Up next, ladies and gentlemen, is a discussion on the topic, how to think, act, and adopt the cloud. Now, the cloud brings flexibility and cost-effectiveness benefits to SMBs, supporting the availability of data and services needed. While there is an uptick seen in the cloud adoption by the SMB sector, but there are still companies who do not realize the benefits of cloud due to the lack of know-how and the limitations of new technologies. In this next session, hear from two leaders in the sector who have realized the importance of not only adopting cloud, but also see an impact it has created to their business. Chairing the session is Aditi Puri Batra, Chief Business Officer, Tata Business Hub. Aditi is a seasoned global business leader with over 23 years of experience and an accomplished track record of building businesses and driving expansion into new markets in India and the US, setting up and scaling sales, marketing, and product organizations, establishing complex strategic partnerships, and incubating C-level relationships in both turnaround and high-growth situations. Joining her on the session are Dr. Vishal Rajgaria, Director and CEO, FineCure Pharmaceuticals Limited, and Philip Thomas, Managing Director, Penveer Products Private Limited. It's a pleasure to have all of you here on this panel. And Aditi, over to you.
Thank you, Justin. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we are here to learn and to get inspired. With me is Dr. Vishal Rajgaria and Mr. Philip Thomas. I'm going to ask them to quickly introduce themselves. So can we start with you, Dr. Vishal?
Hi, very good evening. This is Dr. Vishal Rajgaria. I'm Director and CEO of FineCure Pharmaceuticals Limited. And we deal in pharmaceutical products and healthcare products. And our motto is making lives healthier. And whatever products we deliver and serve is to make people and their lives healthier and happier. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vishal. Mr. Phillips?
Hi, my name is Philip Thomas. I'm the Managing Director of Penveer Products. We're basically a first-time entrepreneur company from Kerala, basically into seafood exports, having two factories, one in Kerala and one in Andhra Pradesh. So what we do is we export seafood out of India. And our major market is basically US. And we started this company about 15 years before I was an employee in another seafood company. We started this company about 15 years before from a turnover of 1 crore. Last year, we achieved a turnover of 600 crores. We have over 3,500 people. Out of the 3,500 people, close to about 3,000 people are women, and who lives below, I won't say poverty level, but basically women. So our company basically is a family-owned company, but started by me with a couple of my friends. I have two more partners, so we are. Yeah, so that's the introduction about our company, and we believe in entrepreneurship development within our company. So, that is what we believe in. That's how we're growing. And that's it. That's a small introduction about us.
Thank you, Mr. Phillips. And thank you, Vishal, for the introduction. As you can see, both these gentlemen are successful entrepreneurs in their own respective industry. And both of them, as we'll learn today, have adopted digital solutions to transform their business and take their operations to newer heights. So let's make sure that we learn from them today. Now, I was reading that according to a KPMG study that was done to see the impact of digitization in India, we know that MSMEs derive significant benefit from digital enablement. Digital MSMEs grow profits 2x faster. We know that 51% of digital MSMEs cater to or are able to cater to customers beyond their own city boundaries, as opposed to 29% of their offline counterparts. Yet, The story is that digital penetration and cloud penetration among MSMEs in India is a mere, can you believe it, 8%. Post-COVID, digital transformation and adoption to the cloud is happening on a scale that is both intimidating as well as promising. It's not an option anymore. It's become a competitive imperative. However, still the lack of know-how among small businesses and the help or the hand-holding that they need remain huge blockers. Out of 65 million small businesses in India, it's a mere 50,000 that are using advanced digital productivity tools. So let's hear from our panelists today and see what we can do to change this. So I'm going to start with you, Vishal. Now, you have said that you believe digitization has become the new normal. Your company has embraced digitization in various parts of your operations to stay relevant. Can you talk to us today about some of the tools that you have adopted to embrace digital? How did you know and when did you know it was time? And who helped you decide which tools to pick?
Rightly said, Aditi. Well, first, talking on the COVID part, I believe that digital business transformation has happened on a huge scale, and it is indeed promising, and digitization has become imperative and is taking to the larger section of the industrial sector. And this is making a great impact on digitization. Now, talking about digitization and technology, well, I believe that technology adoption is very important as it enhances the productivity, improved return on investment output, and gives better insights. So on this, there is a quote which I have penned that technology, IT, and digitization works as air, while machine works as body for the industry and organizations. And hence, tech is as equally important as machines. So when you have body and air, then it totally works in sync, right? So at FindCure, we have been embracing the technology to improve productivity and ease of work for our human resource. Technology is updated where on the need as and when arrived by the human resource by gap identified, and such that it could fortify the work and productivity of our human resource. To recall our journey, we started with cloud document management, email, collaborative tools, and then expanded our horizon to cloud servers and SharePoint and other collaborative tools, right? And these developments were as and when it was arisen by our team. When furthermore, in COVID times, virtual meetings have become regular scenario with suppliers, vendors, customers, all have come in virtual meeting. Furthermore, in pandemic, we have team of medical reps meeting doctors. Doctors refrain to meet to medical reps. So we have doctrined our process such that they can meet or revise our process so that they can have an interaction with doctors without going to their chambers, so that both doctors and our teams are safe and doctors do not hesitate meeting them. So this way we have adopted the technology as per change of time. And technology have helped us a lot, both in our process optimization and helping our human resource as well.
Vishal, how tough was it for you to make that switch? How did you gain the know-how? Did you need a lot of hand-holding, or like talk to us about, you know, the time when you migrated towards the cloud and digitizing your operations? How tough is that to enable the migration?
It was not tough because we have always had a team, and we believed to empower our team. So once we empower our team, then things get through. Even for example, a use case, we had a on-premise ERP, we migrated to SAP ERP, but we have given the entire implementation task to our own team, and they implemented, and then they gave training to our other employees. An entire go-live was very true because the entire task and onus was given to our own team. So when we give the imperative to our team or responsibility to our team, the things get smoother.
Right.
So migration or implementation or adoption becomes easier when the responsibility is given to team. So in that scenario, we have a policy of divide and multiply. So we divide the responsibilities and have multiplied results.
That's interesting. I'm going to come back to you on that, but I have a question for Philip. Philip, when you think of the cloud, what is different for you versus the past? And what is the new value creation that has happened post you adopting the cloud? Would it be possible to give some examples of use cases that may be relevant to your industry and the customers that you serve?
Okay, so basically, when I gave my introduction, I told about who are the people involved in our industry. Most of the people that are involved in our industry are from the downtrodden of the society. So it's not very easy for us to adopt to new technologies. So what we do, we as entrepreneurs also goes with the traditional way of thinking. Everything on the papers, work with the Excel, have a small computer, have accounting system, you have PCs and your own servers here and there. That is how we used to work until about 4 or 5 years before.
Right.
Okay, so what happened is it's a few years before, and the world was moving on. We had to give a lot of information to people. We had to make sure that we made profits and other things. So we needed a lot of information, and which was not available, So that is when about a few years before, probably, we were using email and other things. It was already there. It was basically information collection and how do we use it for our benefit. It was not there. So it was in 2013 or something like that. We probably went into a small ERP. Somebody gave us a presentation of a small ERP. So that is how we came into the ERP. And then we found that in a small way, it is helping. In a small way, it is helping to get the information for us, collide all these informations, and then do our business based on all these informations. It's only a couple of years before we started. We wanted this information to be really, be stored and that we can use it for our business. So that is right. When it changed to the cloud and other things. That is when, TCS basically came to us and talked about us and actually handheld us. Me as an entrepreneur was traveling 4 or 5 times outside, was thinking, oh, it's going to be very expensive. So, it was traditional way of thinking and other things. So when this got introduced and when we moved, we found that it was information was available anywhere, everywhere. We could give access about these information, past informations about, our industry changes prices very faster. The seasonality, we have a lot of variable factors that is in there. And then, when you don't have this information, next year you don't have the same information with you. So we could collide all this information together and we could pass it on to our customers and they were very happy. So what it led to more closeness to the customers who we went to, because I personally had more information with me about, what we can produce, what are the size of, there's a lot of variability, which when we had all this information, we could collide all this together and give it to them so that they used this as a tool to enhance their business, wherein they gave us more information. We started giving them more information and our association became more closer. And that really helped us to transform ourselves. See, for example, our big growth started in 2015 or 2016. We were like a 70 crore company or 80 crore company until 2014. So once we started getting information, we started getting new customers. We could go directly to the end consumer. We could convince them what our capabilities are. And, so digitalization and, of course, has really helped us in growing our company very faster, steadily. And right now, you won't believe, even it's giving more confidence. It's, according to me, people who are working with us were, when I was in Cochin until 2012, the maximum would be a pre-university person. could communicate. Today, you look at it in our Gudur factory, basically all engineers. You know what I'm saying? So, a lot of transformation in terms of, you know, when we introduce technology into the thing, you know, fish smells. People don't want, you know, when they get out of the place, they don't want the smelling, you know, when they go in a bike or a bus or other thing and they go back home. So we could bring in little fashion into the industry. One, by giving information, people could be in a center. You know, we would purchase from the south end of Andhra to north end of. So using all these digitalized platform, we could communicate very well. They could key in the information very well. So it has really transformed the entire industry. And it has done good for us. And it has grown, you know, we have more information. Based on that information, I could make good decisions rather than spontaneous decisions. And it has led to, growth of the company in terms of profitability.
No, that's interesting. And you talked about something, you know, which sparked my interest, and what I come across very often is hand-holding, right? You said literally they hand-held us throughout that entire migration or that transformation as it was happening in your company. Now, if we look at, like, you know, a lot of emerging businesses or small and medium businesses, while they realize the importance of digitization, doing that migration or the thought of, like, how do we go about it, right? Whether it's like lack of awareness or inertia, or to your point, like that hand-holding which is needed, right? Those are some of the barriers that I've come across. So what would your, you know, advice be to emerging businesses that are listening to this panel discussion today, in terms of what can they do to overcome these barriers?
So first of all, you know, entrepreneurs, small entrepreneurs, I would definitely call me a small entrepreneur. You know, small entrepreneurs like me are scared about the cost what we are going to incur. And we are not aware of what the benefits that's going to come to us, you know, when all this is aware, because just talk about it for a day. Oh, okay. I have this information in paper and writing. So what needs to be done is proper education to the entrepreneurs. This is the most important thing that is required for small SMEs to get into digitalization and get into all these cloud solutions and other things. Number one, proper education. You know, I'm not joking. There was a sales guy that really gave me a good talk. You know, he came and met me and showed me all these production modules and what could. So it was the education of the thing. Number two, they were willing to put in their resources to train our people. See, the first impediment is basically the entrepreneur who's very scared about the money part of it. At the end of the day, when I really look at my journey last 3 years, probably I'm getting more benefit in terms of my profit when I have, you know, collide all my information. I'm not taking spontaneous decisions so that I could rely on the facts and figures that used to happen 3 or 4 years, compare it with what is happening today. And I could make my decisions based on that. So the second thing, when I said handholding, there was people that was posted in our company to train our people up. Believe me, we still 30%. Of what we should achieve. You understand? You know, we are in the process. We just 3 years now, we are in the process of implementing our production process. So I can say that we are almost there. You know, we're testing all our reports out and other things. So there was a lot of handholding that was there in terms of training our people also. Our people were stuck, you know, they're all from small town.
Right.
I'm not from Bombay. I'm not from Delhi. I'm not from Chennai, where I could get in resources. You know, I am from a small town where people talk the language, little bit of English, and they come to make their 15,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees. You understand? They migrate to Bangalore to make more money, or migrate to Chennai to make more money. So such kind of, you know, now, and, you know, we have a lot of engineers and, you know, and basically the smaller towns, people want to come back to smaller towns if there are opportunities. So companies like us, if we adopt to technology and can make profits, we can pay more. So people are coming. So resources availability was, can be also solved.
So Philip, basically what you're saying is cost was an important factor. Training, was an important factor. Vishal, what is your perspective? Is it the same for you?
Well, I believe that there are two important factors. First is technology adoption. So whether it is cloud or on-premise, technology adoption and choice is very important. So here the entrepreneurs can get the information from the peers or from associations or from the vendors themselves that what technology there is in store for them and what technology they should adopt. And proper technology adoption as per their industry need or as per their company, that this technology will serve their purpose, and case study to convince them that, this similar company is on board and this case is proven. So ice can be broken that, there is no fear per se to adopt the technology, because the companies are in fear for adoption technology. Now we talk about cloud. When we talk about cloud, the fear of the companies, small companies and emerging companies, are about data theft. We need to nurture them that there is data security there. All the companies are compliant. So you need not worry about data. Nobody is going to take your data. Secondly, the barrier that comes to emerging companies is about they are paying this much rental. And if they have their own server, this much is the cost. They can own the server. So here, knowledge is to be given that the server needs to be discarded after 3 years. And if you go for cloud, so you are paying rentals and you can change the configuration as per your requirement. When you grow, you need to change the servers every 6 months or 2 months. So that kind of knowledge is to be given. So point is, you need to give proper knowledge to emerging companies so that they understand that why cloud is good, why technology is good, how technology are enablers. So problem is people are selling technology as a product, but not as an enabler. So once they start selling technology as enabler to the company, so this cloud will be broken of this fear, and cloud of enabler will be adopted. So I believe, you're saying.
So that's a very interesting point, right? That they need to sell it not like a product, but as an enabler from a knowledge or a know-how perspective. So what are companies not doing right today? Is it that there is lack or lesser investment from an education perspective? Or is it that, physically that handholding is needed? Like, talk to us a little bit more about that.
There are three things. There are too many choices available in market. With too many choices comes too many confusion.
Correct.
So industry will be thinking, what to go for? So they will ask vendors. Every vendor will say, I'll give you this. So sometimes they will offer more than what they have in store. So it should be point blank that, this is the product. This can serve you this. And we have served so-and-so company with similar case study of your requirement. So I think if the company is satisfied that, we have got, we are getting similar product as to what is our need. So I think that could help company to adopt technology much swifter way.
Got it.
And furthermore, if company technology enabler helps companies to assure of technology adoption and this training, even if the cost is involved, then that will be of use. Just like having car, and if you don't know how to drive, that's very important, because digital adoption is done with people at core. If your people are not at core and they don't know how to run the process, so it will not be of value addition. So again, we need the technology company needs to focus the value addition part of the technology, how they're going to add value to the company and corporations. So if the value addition proposition is given, then the adoption will be quicker and swifter.
That's so right, that at the end of the day they need to understand what is the value that's being created. And I think what I'm also hearing from you is, at the end of the day, it's about simplifying right? For entrepreneurs and small businesses, like to Philip's point, there's so much going on just running the day-to-day business. Like, take out the confusion, simplify the message, and, you know, like, guide me to what is to be done. I think that is the need of the hour. No, thank you, Philip and Vishal. This was super helpful. And just some notes that I've taken, especially on the last question, right? I think you brought up some really good points from the government looking at subsidies and schemes going digital to Philip. You talked about skilling centers in small cities and investment in training. White papers, I think, is like a super good point, right? And companies obviously focusing on value creation and simplification, I think, is super important, as well as the cost. And lastly, your point, Vishal, in terms of there's a responsibility that the emerging business has as well in terms of carrying the employees on that journey as well, and empowering them. So thank you so much, you know, for your time, Philip and Vishal. Pleasure having you, and hopefully the folks who listen to us learned a lot today. Thank you.
Bye. All right. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much indeed, Aditi, Vishal, and Philip, for that great discussion.